Just a beautiful tribute to what a special guy he was. We are dedicating a peace pole. We have three peace poles already. There is a group called the Peace Pole Program, and you can go online, look it up, and they are developing and selling and putting out peace poles all over the country. And so for every peace pole they sell, they are donating 10 trees to be planted in the continent of Africa. Just a beautiful tribute to what a special guy he was. We are dedicating a peace pole. We have three peace poles already. There is a group called the Peace Pole Program, and you can go online, look it up, and they are developing and selling and putting out peace poles all over the country. And so for every peace pole they sell, they are donating 10 trees to be planted in the continent of Africa. That's that. Okay, without further ado, I'm going to introduce our wonderful president, Byron Breland, San Jose City College. And
For sort of getting us started and getting us organized here, and of course bringing the event inside in light of the heat. First of all, I want to say thank you to everybody for being here. This is certainly a momentous occasion for us to be honoring Deacon Sal Alvarez with the installation of a peace pole here at San Jose City College. And as Eve Mathias mentioned, you know, there are folks here that I want to acknowledge for being with us, and I want to start out first by introducing formally the mayor of the city of San Jose, Mayor Sam Liccardo. Next, I would like to introduce, sitting right next to him, the vice mayor, Rose Herrera. And someone you're going to hear from very shortly, our supervisor of the County Board of Directors, David Cortese. Master of Ceremonies, and I'll invite him up in a few moments once we go through a few more introductions. And of course, we have folks here from the college that I believe everybody should take a look at who's here. And without further ado, I want to introduce to you our new interim chancellor, Dr. John. Why is your name not coming to my head? Henderson. John Henderson. So with that, I would like to now invite up our Master of Ceremonies, Supervisor Dave Cortese. That's what we do.
Well, thank you, President Breland, for the introduction and for all those other introductions that you just did. It's an honor to be with all of you for this special dedication to the late Reverend Deacon Sal Alvarez. I know many of you in this room would have great stories to share regarding how Sal impacted your life. You would be impacted by Sal's life if you were in contact with him at all, but you'd be impacted by his life even if you weren't in direct contact with him, which is the sign, I think, of a great life lived. We lost him recently. He would be tremendously pleased, given his many roles, including his role in the Catholic Church, to be honored and recognized this way, perhaps, as Vice Mayor Herrera said, at a time, at a special time, when the Pope is en route to Philadelphia. This would be a time when Sal was recognized by Pope Benedict with one of the highest honors that the Pope can bestow just a few years ago. At this time, I ask all of you to join me in welcoming another deacon, Deacon Ruben Solorio for today's invocation.
Good afternoon, everyone. On behalf of Bishop McGrath, he sends his special thanks and appreciation for the life of our beloved Deacon Sal. And, you know, County Supervisor Dave Cortese mentioned mentorship, and I am a proud mentee of Deacon Sal. He taught me acts of love and compassion and de-escalation and peace building and how to ensure that we always put our best foot forward in a respectful and loving way in all that we do in order to ensure that we accomplish our goals in a peaceful manner, even when we create conflict. You know, the end result is always peace. And I remember him for that. And we use this as a way that the three individuals that were mentioned that were civil rights leaders influenced his spirituality. Gandhi and Martin Luther King influenced Cesar Chavez's forming of his spirituality. Well, Deacon Sal was part of that influence. And he embraced all of those three spiritualities to make Deacon Sal's own spirituality, and that's why this invocation is dedicated to him.
It's a moment I'll never forget. If you would have enjoyed greatly working with the current mayor of San Jose, working with the county of Santa Clara and the city to bring us together to do greater things, you know, to get bigger than the parts that we are. That's what he was all about. And so in that spirit, I ask you all to give a big round of applause to the mayor of San Jose, our mayor, my mayor too, Sam Liccardo.
Thank you, Dave. As Supervisor Cortese was speaking, it dawned on me. Oh, thank you. Thanks, appreciate it. Thank you. It dawned on me as Supervisor Cortese was speaking how much Sal would have wanted to have been here today. Here on International Peace Day, Sal, of course, was a passionate proselytizer of peace. But here at San Jose City College, given Sal's commitment and passion for education, particularly education institutions like this one that open opportunity to so many in our community that have been excluded in the past. And he was so passionate, of course, as a former professor at San Jose State, as a co-founder of the Graduate School of Social Work. And how important it would have been for him to be here today, of course, to be part with his here with his family, Sylvia and Sal Jr. and Serena and Sabrina and all his grandchildren and so many of his friends. And of course, he would have wanted to have been here at this moment, but of course he would have wanted to have been outside, sweating in the sun, because that's the way Sal was. But he would have wanted to be here in this moment, as Vice Mayor Herrera pointed out, as the Pope is coming to this country to elevate the social conscience of the country. I know that Sal saw his role very deeply intertwined with that one. That, as so many of us who are members of big families know, there's always one member of the family who is the conscience of the family. And Sal Alvarez was the conscience of our community in so many ways.
So today's Peace Pole dedication to his memory celebrates the work he did and the work that remains in his memory of continuing to forge relationships and to promote peace between members of our expansive and diverse community. I thank you all for being here in celebration of his work and his life. At this time, I'd like to call upon Father John Pedigo, and he will lead us in the dedication ceremony as we dedicate this peace pole to the Reverend Deacon Sal Alvarez. Father John.
Good afternoon. You know, December 10th, 1940, Santa Maria, California, Deacon Sal was born and he died June 7th, 2015 in San Jose. And between those two dates, is filled an just a tremendous amount of events in history. But I just kind of want to touch on a couple things and just add a little commentary. First of all, faith, as we know, played a huge role, and not the central and organizing role, in Sal's life. It colored his view of how he saw the world, why and how he engaged with people in activism, and his love of the UFW and worked with that, with the UFW and all the different causes that came out of that. It's true, he was a mentor. He was one of my mentors. One could say he was more of a tormentor. You know, when he taught about nonviolence, we have to realize that nonviolence doesn't mean non-confrontation, and it doesn't mean simply contemplation. For Sal, and for other leaders that were influenced through him, the nonviolence movement was in fact about confronting the injustice, not the person.
So, I was also reminded of something, though, that I read from Sylvia in one of her, she said that Deacon Alvarez also, you know, was interested in peace, world-like peace, but also within the family. And that was very touching, because that idea that we are a microcosm of something bigger, and our family is what holds us together as well. So I needed to make that statement. All right, so.
Thank you, Professor Mathias. And I want to thank everybody for being here. In particular, I want to thank Deacon Alvarez's family for traveling, so thank you all. I also want to thank our Master of Ceremonies, Supervisor Cortese, for doing a wonderful job. Of course, Mayor Sam Liccardo and Vice Mayor Herrera, who had to leave, by the way, to be in another event, or else they would have stayed here with us. And with that, we want to actually go ahead and bring forward this representation of the Peace Pole. And I want to invite Deacon Alvarez's family to come up. We'd like to just sort of take a few pictures to dedicate the pole. It will be downstairs. We'll take it down there afterwards later, and it will be a formal installation in the ground. And I also want to thank everybody for being here. Deacon Alvarez certainly represents the principles of our community college district, the San Jose State Community College District, in particular those of social justice, and equal access, especially to education for everybody. And with that, actually, we have a few words that folks would like to say regarding. So, yep, sure. You can do that. It's tall. All right.
And then putting himself out there, and then actually putting himself online many times with a lot of sacrifice to himself. And I just want to thank you very much. His work continues. We are working to make sure that we try to involve our families, our Spanish-speaking families, who many times are voiceless because they lack the language, and we're trying very hard to make sure that we provide them with those opportunities. But his vision was also worldwide. And what he came back with was amazing, that what he saw in Africa exists in our country. Apartheid still exists here in our own country. And when he went to Israel and he saw the Palestinians and the Israelis, they still had the same issues our farm workers have here. They are the farm workers in Israel, as the Palestinians. So it kind of gave him a wider view of the fact that we already, maybe the earth is big, but the problems that exist are very similar in our countries, and we need to really work to help support each other to bring peace, and especially not just the world, but peace within our families. But in the end, that's what he found was the most rewarding for him. He was a good organizer, a good strategist. It was amazing how he could put things together to make things happen, but in the end, it was when he worked with families on one-on-one that he really got the joy, and he really began to see the connection of why you need to bring peace within the family, learn to resolve the conflicts, and yet as parents, we had to learn to give some time to our young adults so that they can learn from their own mistakes, but have the presence of their families as guides in their lives. So that took a while for him to get, because believe me, we had a lot of conflict at home, and he was a dad. It was hard for him to let them have their sense of autonomy, but that's what he learned, having had that experience. So anyway, I want to thank you very much for having us, And on behalf of my family, we are very grateful. Thank you.
We just ask everybody to spend a few minutes fellowshipping and getting to say hello to folks before you take off. We have some refreshments right there. So again, thank you all for being here.
So anybody, any student that needs...
Nice dad.
Hey, any students?
I got some candy for President Byron Breland.
Please enjoy the refreshments.